I used the new box for the turn up as well. Still my size. This is something I always do. There's nothing about the smell of new sneakers.
I'm 24 years old. I study game design at Hanze in Groningen. I think I've been collecting sneakers since I was 15. That's when it really started. My interest in sneakers began, I think, when I watched some Korean pop videos. And they always wear flashy clothes in the video clips. And I think I saw a few dancers who had flaming shoes and shoes with wings on them. And I looked them up and bought them. So as I mentioned, when I was young, I had these Korean, Japanese idols who basically had like a certain style that I tried to like, not necessarily copy, but chase after. For now, what I personally take a lot of inspiration of is Japanese anime. And that really inspires me. At the moment, I own 40 pairs. But I have 20 pairs here, still 20 pairs at back at my old home. But I have a rotating 10 pairs that I actually wear at the moment.
My name is Michael Zelderist. I'm 25 years old. I've been living here in Groningen for all my life. Just finished my bachelor at sports science and now I'm studying to be a healthy aging professional. In my spare time, I like to play basketball, like to listen to music, go out with friends, collecting sneakers. I'd say been collecting sneakers for over 10 years. I'd say between 10 and 12 years. I probably started when I was 14, 13, about that age, yeah. My interest began at a very young age. My mom, she's from the Dominican Republic, and she, when we went on vacation there, I got to pick a pair of basketball shoes to play in, because basketball shoes there were less expensive, and they were much more fire, they were much more good looking. I do get my inspiration from the internet. Most of the time it's basketball players because they do have a similar style as me. And I like to watch some older styles as well because everything retro comes back again. And I like to incorporate that with my own style as well. Just wearing something that's casual, that's comfortable and just feels good and looks good as well, yeah. I think I have between 60 and 70 pairs at the moment, including all my basketball sneakers as well.
I decide what sneaker to wear based on the kind of clothes I want to wear as well. So obviously if you wear an outfit and the sneakers are different, then it sometimes just doesn't work. But it also happens that sometimes I have an outfit and then I put on shoes, but some shoes are not as comfortable as some other pairs. So I might then last moment switch to a different pair, which also leads to a different outfit. I have a few pairs that I usually go to, which are my favorite, also comfort wise and also style wise. So if I don't really know, I just go back to those and then it will take 10 minutes. My main sneaker brand would probably be Adidas. I started with them. The flaming wing sneakers were Adidas. They were designed by Jeremy Scott, a collaboration with Adidas. So these were my first pair of expensive or designer sneakers maybe. I really like to just have them as like a memory of the past, and they still look really cool. Sadly, they're not comfortable. My most worn sneakers is definitely the Human Races by Pharrell. They are sleek, they can go with a lot of outfits, and they're really comfortable. So they're like always a good choice. And they're releasing in so many colors now, and they're easier to pick up with every new release. So yeah, it's definitely a sneaker that I keep going back to.
I don't always shop in the same stores, online most of the time, not really in the physical stores. Favorite brand, yeah, I would say that would be Nike or Jordan brand, but I like to differentiate between brands as well, trying to get some of the other cool sneakers, because Nike isn't the only wave that I'm riding, and like to, yeah, pick and choose what I would decide to buy. I do have some favorites. I think it depends on my mood and also the outfit. Some shoes just go with everything, like this is yellow, but it doesn't go with everything I wear. Also, it's suede, that's not most of the time very wearable. And there's just some sneakers which are very classic and they feel good, so I lean more towards them.
I spend a lot of time looking up sneakers on the internet, on social media or YouTube, Instagram, to basically keep up with all the releases. This year, there's so many releases every month, it's hard to keep up. And if you're searching it up all by yourself on the internet, checking every retailer, every brand for all the releases, it will take you way too long. So nowadays, I just check up on YouTube or Instagrammers who have like the releases ready for you. So next week, there will be a new drop of Yeezys, the Yeezy 500 in the salt colorway. I'm actually trying to pick those up. It's gonna be pretty easy for me to pick up because the women's sizes are way more popular. So I'm definitely gonna try those next week. And I think it will be on the Adidas site in 8 in the morning. So I'm trying to buy a pair of Yeezys, but they drop at 8 in the morning. And I have classes at 8:30, but it takes me like 30 minutes to cycle from my home to school. So if I tried to cop them at home, I would be late. Usually back in the day, you would have to go to a store early in the morning and stand in line. So that might be exciting to just camp in front of a store with other people you know, or people you meet. But nowadays, it's mostly online raffles. And you get an email or a text message, and then you show up in the morning. This is the most fun part. You're basically waiting in a queue, and you see all the sizes, and you slowly see sizes being sold out. So 38 just got sold out. And after a while, I'm in, and then I can select my size. But now it's just waiting, and I've seen all the sizes get sold. So usually, Yeezys would sell out instantly. Like immediately, like if you're a little bit late, they're gone. But recently, since there are already like so many pairs of them, especially because Kanye wants everybody to have Yeezys, so he made them more accessible, more pairs, more stock. And with more stock, they get less resale value, so they get less and less hype. And it usually shifts to a new pair. So at the moment, Nike is doing really great again. So it took a while, but I mean, my size is still available.
So it's 8:23, I managed to get them, and I'm right in time for class.
I've been to, I think, 3 or 4 sneaker conventions here in the Netherlands. Super chill environment. I've been only on the Sundays. I've been told the Sundays are much more chill. Some say the quote-unquote good sneaker deals are most of the time they're gone by Sunday, but I don't really mind that. I'm more there for the environment, just to be with people around me who are also very much into sneakers and fashion and the whole scene.
For yourself? Or?
Yeah, okay. For myself. And
all right, nice.
Okay. So I didn't want to choose, so.
Okay,
you like them?
Yeah, I like them.
Yeah.
Are you going to wear them? Or
yeah. Okay. I wear everything. Yeah.
Well, cool. Well, thank you.
Well, this is a very special pair to me. This is the Jordan 1 Shattered Backboard. It's maybe one of the most hyped shoes, or at least Jordan 1s in the world. They actually have risen in value. My pair, I think, goes in that stock condition for maybe 800 to 900. And I really enjoy the story behind these as well. Because Michael Jordan, he was playing an exhibition game in Italy, and somewhere mid-game, Michael Jordan, he went to dunk the ball, and he actually shattered the backboard. Actually, in the inside, there is a insole with some gloss and some piece of the backboard or rim, and actually pretty nice touch as well. I think that's pretty cool to have a piece of history like this, and people are also going crazy about the leather type. They say, yeah, it's a shattered backboard quality, but I actually have to admit the leather, the orange and the cream pieces are very nice and plush. Like the cool people say, they're butter. These were mine, and actually pretty fun to see these next to some of my shoes I'm wearing today. because it's just funny to see how my feet have grown over the years from a, well, I don't really know what size these are, but these are size 12. And as you can see, you can probably fit maybe, well, almost 2.5 of my baby shoes within one shoe. So that's pretty cool as well. And well, maybe I'll give these to my future children someday. I would say I do spend a lot of money on sneakers, definitely. Yeah, I'd say maybe this pair is one of the most expensive pairs I have in my collection. But if you would say maybe emotional value, I would say this pair does mean a lot more to me than this pair. But this one will get you more money, so it's yeah, it can be a pain sometimes. But I'd say give me the more emotional value than rather than a money value.
So I got the Yeezy 500 salts yesterday. The colorway turned out to be more similar to the original blush than I expected. From the pictures, I expected a bit more of a gray colorway instead of the more similar blush one. It's fine, I still like them. I was kind of scared, since I mostly wear Boost nowadays, that I wouldn't like them. But I've been walking on them for the past, well, since when I got them. And so far, so good. They are a bit more warmer than the Boost, since most of the Boosts have prime knits, just like the human races. So for winter, this is gonna be really nice. I can definitely see myself picking up a new colorway when they drop. There were some leaks of a more pinkish orange colorway, so really looking forward to that, especially since they fit well. Yeah, overall I think a great shoe, especially for the colder weather, if you like that easy aesthetics.
Sneakers are in fact very expensive, and if I'd say this whole row could have given me a very nice vacation in a foreign country, and experience is also very valuable as well. But it's something I decided not to do, to have some sneakers. But I also see this as an art piece as well, and something I can invest my money in, and it can rise or dip in time as well. So it's, I kind of also see it like an investment. But I think it's good to be conscious of the money you're spending into sneakers, just knowing that it could be spent for something else. Just keeping that in the back of your mind is important, I think. At least I think I won't stop, because I'm still very enthusiastic about sneakers, still like to wear them. I couldn't see myself not being a sneaker fanatic. Maybe slowing down a bit and maybe more picking and choosing what I'm trying to buy. But stopping, no, probably not. Maybe some kind of financial dip will occur and I need to sell some pairs, but I'll probably never sell my whole collection, yeah.
I do sometimes think I shouldn't spend so much on sneakers, since, yeah, they cost a lot. It's kind of like a hobby as well, because there's like a certain line that you just want to collect more of them. And for me, those are the human races. I can see myself wearing them forever. I can definitely see myself collecting sneakers when I get older. I don't know what my taste will be like in the future, but I can see myself still buying the Pharrells. I don't know, I might have like a change of heart when I get older and maybe stick to nice boots, but unless boots get as comfortable as sneakers, I definitely don't see that happen.
Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know when it's here. My dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah. I tried to show him. Yeah, 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 yeah. Gone on you with the pick and roll. Young the flame, he in sicko mode. Yeah. Astro.